that is a candidate is able to have, I'm not taking your time, is able to have their representatives at the polls to be a poll watcher, just like the Republican or the Democratic Party can. So thank you, Christy, for allowing us to do this, and thank you, Janet, for getting us these timely, and thank you for what you're doing.
Well, thank you all so, so much for allowing me to be with you tonight. Before I get started, though, I have to give just congratulations to our elections team back in our office. We have such a fantastic group. I can tell you, they're still back at the office, still working. They will be there until almost 7 o'clock tonight, as we are now on our second day of early voting. Over 625 people have early voted today, over 500 people early voted yesterday. We had our very first canvassing board meeting today, starting at 9:30. We canvassed over 3,000 ballots. So we are over 6% voter turnout so far. Early voting will continue from yesterday until August 17th, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. each of those days. But I can't say enough great things about our elections team, not only our staff, but our poll workers, and I'm going to give a shout out to our community advisory as well, our advisory council. And I know we've got two members here tonight. We've got Sheila, we've got Deb. We started this advisory council in June of 2021. We brought together individuals from all across Nassau County who have different philosophies, people who don't think necessarily the same. It was a little bit of this at the beginning, but we did it because we wanted to be able to build trust. We want to have transparency and opportunity for two-way communication. And we've been able to achieve that. When you ask me what the number one issue is for elections in Nassau County, it is making sure that we have trust in Nassau County elections. Because if you don't trust your elections, what do you have? And so creating that opportunity for questions to be asked and for them to be answered in a respectful manner and having that dialogue has been absolutely transformational in Nassau County. So I want to thank you both publicly for participating in that. It has been fantastic. So I'm a fifth generation North Floridian. I have a BS degree in information science. I have an MBA. I've served you in the Florida House. I'm nationally certified in elections. I'm a fiscal conservative. Over the last three budget years, we've returned over $1.5 million back to the Board of County Commissioners. Why? Because we budget for worst case scenario, but then we spend conservatively. I'm not gonna spend your money unless we need it. And so we returned over $1.5 million back to the Board of County Commissioners over the last three fiscal years. There's actually an article that I put on the back table. I invite you to pick it up. Steve Nicholas wrote this article, it was in the Newsleader back, I think it was in April. So I encourage you to read that. You don't have to believe me, you can listen to what other people say as well. We just received four national awards. Four national awards, Nassau County. I'm told it's the first ever that this has happened, where any elections office has received four national awards in a given year. And that's because we've got a great team. We've got a team that is built on trust and respect. Is my time over? Are you sure you can take
it?
Say the other key issue is election security. So we're going to absolutely maintain that list. That is the foundation of election security. So if you have a list that you want us to look at, or you think people shouldn't be on it, send it to us. Jack knows. He sent us a list of 203 individuals. We've processed that list, and we're continuing to process it. Thank you so much. I ask for your vote. Janet Adkins, I'm your supervisor of elections. God bless you.